Hello friends, welcome back. In this session, let's try to look at one interesting example related to arithmetic progressions. We have been given that four numbers are in AP such that their sum is 4 and the product is 105 or 105. We have to find them. So, the general way of approaching this problem is we just take the numbers as A, A plus D, A plus 2D, and A plus 3D, and then apply the conditions that we have to add them up, then we have to product them. By adding them, you get a relation in A and D, then you find out the product in A and D, substitute D value in A. So that becomes a little bit complicated. So I will just give you the better way to deal with these type of problems whenever you have been given 3 or 4 or 2 problems. So for that we will divide that into 2 parts. If the numbers are even like 4 example, or if the numbers are odd like 3 or 5 for example. So what we are trying to do now, we are going to place the numbers in such a way, we are going to pick or choose the numbers in such a way that the number selection itself is going to give us one extra condition. So for even, I will say the numbers are A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D. Now can you see that these four numbers are in arithmetic progression because the common difference is 2D anywhere you check. And you are starting with a number, then you are adding, that means you are in arithmetic progression. So whenever they say even, always make sure that you pick the numbers in this way. If it is 2, take A minus D, A plus D. If it is 4, A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D. If it is 6, add one more, go one more here, one more here. It becomes A plus 5D and also becomes here A minus 5D. That's about the evens. Now suppose it is odd. Now you understood why we are picking like this? If you say these four numbers are the numbers what we are trying to take, why we are selecting them? Because if you add them, if you observe, the D terms cancel out and you get the value of A directly. Now that's a bonus to us. So we can leverage that, and when calculating the product, it will be very easy for us because we can substitute the value of A, whatever we obtain from the sum. So that's how we can do it easily. We will do that problem. Before that, let me complete odd also, so that any type of problems where you have 3 or 5 numbers with couple of conditions like sum and sums of squares or product or first and last product plus second and third, something like that, whatever may be the conditions, you can easily solve them. Now odd numbers, let us say you have odd. Now idea is to make D cancel. So I will say A minus D, A plus D. Now see here, if you add all the 3, the D terms cancel and you get 3A. Now suppose somebody says I have 5 numbers, okay, you don't have any problem. I will add one more here and you can extend this how many numbers you want. So if you are able to follow this particular pattern, then it is very easy for you to solve these type of problems whenever somebody says 2 numbers, 3 numbers or 4 numbers in AP with couple of conditions. So you can easily solve them. So let's look at this problem which was created by me. 4 numbers are in AP such that their sum is 4 and the product is 105. Find them. Let's have a look at them. So as we discussed earlier, let the numbers be A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, and A plus 3D. It's given that the sum of them is equal to 4. So let us try to add them, equate it to 4. You know that D terms cancel. We end up with 4A equal to 4. That gives us A equal to 1. Bingo, we got the value of A. So if you are able to get the value of D, then we know all the numbers because we can just do A minus 3D, A minus D, A plus D, A plus 3D. Okay, now to find out the D, we have to use our second condition. The second condition says the product is 105. So let me write it down. The product is 105. That means A minus 3D into a minus d into a plus d into a plus 3d equal to 105. Now, do you see that if you rearrange them, you have it in the form of a minus b into a plus b, a minus b into a plus b. So, can I go ahead and write it as a square minus d square, that's for the middle two ones, and the other is a square minus 9d square, because we know the formula a minus b into a plus b equal to a square minus d square. Now, this is nothing but equal to 105. So, I am looking at a quadratic equation now. So, we know the value of a value is 1. So, can I say 1 minus d square into 1 minus 9d square equal to 105? Now, to make it a quadratic equation, I will take d square equal to x, so that I can simplify that easily. It becomes 1 minus x into 1 minus 9x equal to 105. Or if I make it a quadratic equation, I'll have 9x minus 1 into x minus 1 minus 105 equal to 0. Let's simplify that. We will have 9x square minus 9x minus x plus 1 minus 105 equal to 0. That gives me 9x square minus 10x minus 104 equal to 0. Now, we have to use splitting the middle terms, or you can use quadratic form. Any type, anything, whatever you want, you can do. Okay, let us use splitting the middle terms. Now, the sum is equal to minus 10 and the product is equal to minus 104 into 9. Now, I see that sum is negative and the product is also negative. That means the bigger number is negative and the smaller number is positive. So, I have to look for now subtraction of two numbers such that it is equal to 10, and I multiply, I should get 936. So, I will take them as minus 36 and 26, so that minus 36 plus 26 is minus 10, and also minus 36 into 26 is nothing but minus 936. How I got it is very simple. Minus 104, I can write it as minus 26 into 4 into 936. Okay. Now, what will be my next statement if I come back to the quadratic equation? It will be 9x square minus 36x plus 26x minus 104 equal to 0. That gives me 9x into x minus 4 plus 26 into x minus 4 equal to 0. So, let me just erase that. So, the next step will be 9x plus 26 into x minus 4 equal to 0. We are talking about x equal to d square, and here I see 9x is minus 26. I can't have negative values, so this is ruled out. X equal to 4. But what is x? X is nothing but d square. So, d square equal to 4. That gives me d equal to plus or minus 2. So, now let's go back and try to find out the numbers. The numbers we know are a minus 3d, a minus 3d, a minus d, a plus d, and a plus 3d. What is the value of a? A equal to 1. What's the value of d? D is, let us say, plus 2. Then I will have 1. I will have 1 minus 6, that's minus 5. 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. 1 plus d, that is 3. Then 1 plus 3d, 3 into 2 is 6, so it's a 7. If you take negative values, actually you will get in the reverse. You will get 7, 3, माइनस फाइव एंड माइनस वन। इफ यू टेक माइनस टू यू विल हैव वन, या ए प्लस थ्री डी। वन मिनट, आई जस्ट गेव देम इन द रॉन्ग देयर, आई जस्ट फिक्स इट। दिस इज माइनस वन एंड माइनस फाइव। हाउ वी गॉट दोज वैल्यूज इज ए इक्वल टू वन, फर्स्ट केस वी टुक डी इक्वल टू प्लस टू, देन ए माइनस थ्री डी वन माइनस सिक्स, वन माइनस टू वन प्लस टू एंड वन प्लस सिक्स, दैट्स इक्वल टू माइनस फाइव माइनस वन थ्री एंड सेवन। इफ यू टेक डी इक्वल टू माइनस टू देन यू विल हैव ए माइनस थ्री डी वन माइनस ऑफ टू इंटू माइनस थ्री, दैट्स वन प्लस सिक्स। देन आई विल हैव वन प्लस टू हियर, आई विल हैव वन माइनस टू एंड वन माइनस सिक्स। सो द नंबर्स आर सेवन थ्री माइनस वन माइनस फाइव आर माइनस फाइव माइनस वन थ्री सेवन। यू एड दम अप यू विल गेट टेन माइनस सिक्स फोर, फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज सैटिस्फाइड। यू मल्टीप्लाई दम सेवन थ्री जर ट्वेंटी वन, ट्वेंटी वन फाइव जर वन नॉट फाइव, माइनस इंटू माइनस इज पॉजिटिव। सो दैट्स हाउ यू कैन सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम्स। सो रिमेंबर इफ इट इज इवन यू टेक दम लाइक ए माइनस डी ए प्लस डी विथ ए कॉमन डिफरेंस ऑफ टू and extend it in both the direction based on numbers, how many numbers you want. If it is odd you take them as a minus d a plus d and extend it with a common difference of d to the directions, both the directions, based on how many numbers you need. So I'll catch you in the next session with another interesting problem. Thanks for your time and support. Bye for now.